how come nobody's talking about this project? You know, I was like, there are certain things that amazes me within the community. One of the things that amazes me within the community is that the first thing, one of the things I believe in life in general, if you want to actually have the sources that is very, very distinguishable from every other person, you have to be ready to put in the pain so that you can get the gain. If not, it's going to elude you. This project, I'm like, when I checked YouTube, how come nobody is talking about this project? We'll see the team and you'll be amazed what this platform wants to do. This platform wants to become the LinkedIn, the new LinkedIn. Now, LinkedIn had some flaws. Like, LinkedIn does not really authenticate people's data. So someone can actually put online that my email is this. Yeah, I have been working in this place. This is my profile, and actually fake the data. But this platform, they wants to actually change the way it is being done. So if you discover that if you've done business internationally, there is the issue of how do I know that this the information I saw about this person is actually true. TraDove, we solved that project problem. Mind you, they've been in operation for 5 years now, and I will show you some of the things the companies they've actually worked with. So business to business challenges, they talk about the issues of restricted transparency. Then you have a difficult buyer and seller discovery, like something like Google, for example. Google is their consumer oriented, so the displays they actually give to the people may not actually fit into the business to business realm. Then you have the issue of the lack of targeted business to business advertising, and you have the limited trust in international trade. So from the white paper, they are proposing something where, in case you're looking for a business partner, you'll be able to see the profile of people, you'll be able to see their reputation over time, you'll be able to see the reviews on them over time, because these things are on the blockchain and nobody can actually erase or actually edit them. You'll be able to see if these people are actually worth working on in the rest of them. So this is their approach. What's the approach? Create business to business transparency, utilize social network functions such as endorsement and references to authenticate users and reduce due diligence effort and time. Then the other approach is facilitate buyer and user interaction. So they will be using machine learning and big data and also AI into the system, implement AI technologies to optimize the matching of buyers and sellers based on business objective and user profiles. Then precision of business to business advertising, talk about that. Then disrupt business to business payment solution. So there's nothing like banking issues and rest of them with their own cryptocurrencies. Payments will be almost instantaneous, and they will also build trust with the blockchain within the system. So they've been operating for a while now, and these are they worked with over 250,000 users, over 100 plus companies, over 1,000 companies, being 80 countries, and 5 years of operation. These are some of the clients. So if you go through this, you'll see some of the clients they've actually worked with: Nokia, Nikon, Nestle, Denbrenda, Mask, Oye, Toyota, City, Wipro, Stochastra, KBRO. These are some of the brands. You can actually verify these things yourself. BMW, these are the countries they've actually worked in. You can go through Nigeria, many of them. Then other companies, you see 2D Dream, tons of these are the for the 5 years they've been working. So when I'm like, how come nobody knows about this thing? Okay, let's go to in the system you can actually run advertisements also. So let's see the team. So it was funded by Kenty Yang, former founder and CEO at Brainsys International Trade, MS Masters, MIT, Electrical Engineering. Then you have Matt Kianta. So this, you can check his profile, PepsiCo, MIT, Bristol, UPS, FedEx. Then you have Jean Sheng. You see the profile, Alibaba, Tencent, Microsoft. These are guys who have experience OLT, BT, Orange, George Sheng, Network Security, Big Data, Salesforce, IBM, Amazon. No. You don't have to miss this project. Then you have Rick Ross, Jerry Liu, engineer at Facebook. So when you have a team like this, Cisco, then you have investors and advisors, Richard Rosenberg, former chairman and CEO of Bank of America. You can't ignore a project like this. It's former CFO of Morgan Stanley. You can't ignore a project like this. Then you have the former CEO of Siemens. No. You have to have a deep thought if you ignore a project like this. Then you have Gary Cogwe, former group VP of General Motors. Then you have Goldman Kaufman, Professor Emeritus, MIT Sloan School of Management. Dr. Natasha Lauterbach, former SFB Deutsche Telekom. No, you don't have to ignore a project like this. Then Mike Hunger, retired US Congressman. Mario Rosatin. Then you have Shen Sheng Liu, Deng School of Management, Fudan University, China. You can't ignore a project like this. You have all this combination of people, token offering partners and advisors, Carl Gray, and tons of them. Then you have the media coverage. You can actually find them on different platforms, Facebook, LinkedIn, and the rest of them. People from different platforms, former CEO of MasterCard and the rest of them. You want to ignore this project? Don't try it. Listing price is 80 cents. Current pre-sale price is 60 cents. And the minimum you can buy is $3,000, which is 5,000 coins. And the pre-sale ends in 47 days. You can actually get in, or you can get in during the ICO. So guys, please look into this project before you actually toss it off. On YouTube, a lot of people may not be saying a lot of things about it, but I'm bringing it to you so you become the first comer in the system. I told you the space, the rule of the game is to be the early bird. Why nobody is even talking about it? Why there is no hype around it? You get in, you sit down, you relax. Why it's it's 60 cents now. Why this thing is jumping to maybe $40 and the rest of the people are like saying on YouTube, buy this coin and thank me later. You would have gotten it earlier. The rule of the game is the early bird gets the worm. Do have a very, very good day. If you have any comments, share this video with your friends. Do have a very good day.